how to live this life in the midst of pestilence and famine. 5 things to cheerfully become victorious of this crisis. Repentance. Repentance includes sorrow for sin and a turning away from it. We shall not renounce sin unless we see its sinfulness. Until we turn away from it in heart, there will be no real change in the life. Found in the Steps to Christ, page 23. If we want to become victorious, we must confess our sins to God. All our lying, adultery, stealing, greediness, dishonoring our parents, breaking the Sabbath commandment, worshipping the idols, and taking the name of the Lord in vain. In 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verses 13 to 15, God promised to Solomon this: if I shut up heaven that there be no rain, or if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Now mine eyes shall be opened and mine ears attend unto the prayer that is made in this place. Second is become healthy. How to fight diseases? Boosting the immune system. Eat fruit, vegetables, legumes like lentils and beans, or nuts and whole grains. Exercise like walking is great for the lungs, and especially if made at the open air. Sleep is very important, which the athlete like LeBron James do. Avoid drinking alcohol or smoking cigarettes, which weakens immunity to illness. Like it says in 1 Corinthians 6, verse 19, our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. And third is prayer and reading the Bible. In 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 17, it says, pray without ceasing. Ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. God can answer our prayers if He wills to remove the sickness. Also, we must know the will of God in humility by reading the Bible. We can read what's happening now in Matthew 24, verse 7. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places. So it's very clear in the Word of God. Fourth is unity. With cooperation, we become Father, art in me, and I in thee, that they also may be one in us, that the world may know that thou hast sent me and hast loved them as thou hast loved me. It's found in John, verse 17, chapter 17, verse 21 to 23, in Education 86. Like a hard broom, it can hardly sweep if alone, but if many, it can do much. We must be also a good Samaritan to our neighbor who are suffering from sickness or hunger, whatever their religion is or whatever their race is. Last is to prepare to meet the Lord. As the end draws near and the work of giving the last warning to the world extends, it becomes more important for those who accept present truth to have a clear understanding of the nature and influence of the testimonies which God in His providence has linked with the work of the third angel's message from its very rise. It's found in Testimonies for the Church, volume 5, page 654. This is not to generalize all. Some who know the truth are doing nothing to share the gospel truth. God is coming and God will be asking us if we share the truth who are in darkness. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. It's found in Matthew 5, verse 16. Thanks for listening and God bless.